Dear students, myself Dr. Nayan Talukdar, and let's start our next physics practical. The aim of the experiment is to determine the focal length and power of a concave lens by auxiliary lens method. This auxiliary lens method means we use a convex lens to determine the focal length of a concave lens. The apparatus required for the experiment are one optical lens, two lens stand, two pin stand, one concave lens and one convex lens. So before going to the experiment, let us get a clear picture of the arrangement to find the focal length of the concave lens with the help of a ray diagram. Consider a convex lens L1. O1 is the optic center of the lens. The line passing through the optic center is the principal axis. First and foremost, an object needle is placed on the left side of the convex lens, and its real and inverted image I is located by the image needle. Now, a concave lens L2 is placed in between the convex lens and the image I. As we know, the concave lens diverges the light, ray of light. So now the image is formed at I dash. Here I is the virtual object and I dash is the real image. Here the distance between O2 and I gives the value of U, and the distance between O2 and I dash gives the value of V. So this is all about the ray diagram. So the focal length of a concave lens is given by the relation F equal to UV by P minus U, where U equal to distance between O2 and I, and V equal to V is the distance between O2 and I dash. So now let's go to the experiment. As I told in the introduction, this is the image, this is the optical lens, this is the image pin holder, this is the concave lens holder, this is the convex lens holder, and this is the object pin. Now remove the concave lens from the optical lens. Shift the object pin to the one end of the optical lens and note down the reading. Now before doing the experiment, you have to find out the rough focal length of the convex lens. The details of how to find out the rough focal length is already mentioned in the earlier videos. You just go through it and find out the focal length. Now for this convex lens, we have found the focal length is around 23 cm, and we have to set the image pin near about 23 cm from the convex lens. So it is 23 cm from the convex lens. Now bring the image pin, convex lens and object pin holder close to each other. Now adjust the two pin and the lens holder in such a way that the tips of the pin and the optic center of the line in a straight line parallel to optical lens. Now shift the object pin to its original position. Now move the image pin slowly away from the convex lens and set it to around 23 cm. Set it around 23 cm so that we can get a clear image of the object pin. You can now see a clear image of the object pin over the image pin. Yeah, you can see the object pin over the image pin. Now you can see that the two pins are coincides, and there is no relative shift of the pin. If there is any relative shift, you just adjust it by the screw of the concave lens, and this is called parallax correction. Now note down the position of the image pin in the optical lens, and again note down the position of the convex lens. Now put the concave lens in between the convex lens and the image pin. Make it tight. As we know that the concave lens diverges the ray of light, so the image formed by the concave lens is now somewhere formed beyond the earlier position of the image pin. So we have to focus the position by adjusting the concave lens and the image pin. So just adjust the image pin and the concave lens slowly. Now you can see the object pin over the image pin, a clear object of the object pin over the image pin. If there is any parallax, just remove it by adjusting the screw of the concave lens. And note down the position of the image pin in the optical lens. Also note down the position of the concave lens. So this reading is for just one set. The same procedure has been repeated 3 times by changing the position of the uprights, and observations are noted down lens holder. Now we will go to the calculation part. Now let's come to the results and discussion part. Here the first thing you have to do is the index correction part. So for the index correction, you have to take the actual length of the rod, that is the length between the object tip needle and the image tip needle, and the apparent length of the rod, that is the position of the object pin and the image pin from the optical bend scale. So you have to add or subtract the values accordingly as it required in the experiment. So here the index correction is x equal to l plus minus l dash, and corrected value of u equal to u dash plus minus x, or corrected value of v equal to v dash plus minus x. So the details of the index correction we have already explained in our earlier videos. You just go through it and do it accordingly. So this is the main table of the experiment. Here you have to put the different readings you have taken in the experiment. So here first one is the position of the convex lens L1. So you have to note down the position of the convex lens L1 from the optical lens reading. Next is the image for the convex lens I, that is the image formed by the convex lens. You have to note down this position and put the value here. Then mean I, you have to find out the mean I. Now position of the concave lens L2, here you have to put the values from the optical lens. And next you have to put the image for concave plus convex lens I dash, that is the image from after placing the concave lens here, you have to put the values of I dash from the optical lens reading, and after that mean I dash. Then apparent distance you have to find accordingly, and after that index correction value as I told earlier, and after that corrected value u equal to u dash plus x and v equal to v dash plus x. After that you use this formula f equal to u v by u minus v, and put these values here and find out the value of f. So you have to take the 3 sets of reading, and after finding out the f, you have to find out the mean f. After that, focal length of the concave lens is given by this formula. You have to put the values here and you will get the value of f in centimeter. So this is all about the experiment, how to find out the focal length of a concave lens using a convex lens. Hope you have understood the experiment. Thank you.